Right, we have a volunteer for active duty, namely one of our live baits that we caught this morning. Now, I mean, obviously, the plastic lures have been working pretty good, and so have the dead baits. So, we'll throw in a live bait and we'll see how that goes as well. It's kind of a, if you like, a bit of a cross between a dead bait and a live bait. It's obviously real, like the dead pilchards we're using, but it's also going to wriggle around and give a little bit of action, just like the old soft plastic does. So that's just got a 2 ounce ball sinker on top of it. 30 meters below is where I'll lower him, and we'll see if it can't, that wriggling live bait won't trigger the predatory instinct of a big snapper. Oh, got a good one on there, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. Are you ready?
Yeah,
it's a nice one, isn't it?
Yeah, and man, that was that whole thing about, as you explained to me, getting it off the bottom and just flicking it around to try and get that sort of motion happening, and then cupping, bro.
Jumped on it.
Well, jumped on it.
I mean, you'll find that the fish are, there is a hot bite going on, let's not deny that.
Yeah.
But when the fish aren't biting so well, quite often it's that action of the lure or the action of your live bait that will entice them into a bite when they're not really hungry. And that's one of the beauties of using a lure or a plastic over a bait. You got a nice one on there.
Yeah. I'm not rushing anything.
No, enjoy it, mate, enjoy it. Look, glinting in the sun, just got just nice and easy, leave him in the water, just still got a little bit of go in him.
He has,
oh, just this way, beautiful, mate.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah, that's.
And you're dead right, it is over 10 pound, mate.
Yeah, awesome, buddy.
There you go.
Fantastic.
Pounced on it.
You beauty.
Now there's a lesson in retying your knot every so often. Because, I mean, we've caught a lot of snapper on this jig head, as I was just saying, and those teeth just wear away on the knot. You see the lure sitting in this gob there. Oh, hello, my live bait's been eaten.
Ring number
2. I don't care who's ringing. I'm fishing.
Oh, yes, mate.
There you go, that's on the live bait. Now, Peel, I mean, that is the largest fish you've caught today.
Yes, it is.
How would you feel about the proposition of actually letting that one go?
I'm into it.
You're into it?
I'm into it. We've got plenty of cake.
We have, mate.
The wife will be happy, and that's the main thing.
Okie doke.
Okay.
Rightio, well, I'll let you take care of that, and I'll watch this rod with a snapper on it.
I think I beat my record.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, awesome, mate. A personal best day.
I think it was 18 pounds.
Oh, well, we might just have to do something about that then.
Yeah.
Well done. Always good to see those nice ones go back, isn't
it? Oh, yeah, awesome, mate.
Beautiful. Well done.
The breeders.
I tell you what, I mean, we've caught them on dead baits, soft plastics. I think we're about to catch one on a live bait.
But the reaction to the live bait has been pretty instant.
Oh yeah, I mean, I put it down there, helped you with your fish, put my rod in the rod holder. And of course that live bait, the good thing about it, he's wiggling away down there, attracting the attention of the snapper around. And I often found that having a live bait out is better than burley, because any sort of wounded fish is putting out an electronic signal to the big predatory fish. Yeah. And as you've seen, these big snapper are predatory. These big snappers will jump on those plastics, anything moving.
They got attitude.
Yeah, they have. Yeah. People just think that they're a slow-moving mooching.
Yeah.
No, they're a predator. I can just feel the big heavy thumps. Obviously, I mean, this is only 6 kg tackle, but because I've been using that light 4 kilo braid set, I mean, this feels like big game fishing gear. Oh, here he comes. Okay, you're going to pull that sinker in, bro.
Oh,
it's a big one. It's a real big one. No. The slack line, pull the slack line. Yep. Pull the slack line. Oh my God, look at the size of it.
That's crazy.
Just slowly. Just slip that net under him, bro. Slip that net under him. Okay, now that's what happens when you use a live bait. That's pushing 30 pound, that fish. Look
that's
at the
crazy.
Stomach on it. Look at the stomach on it. It's like a harp hooker. Oh my God.
That's crazy, bro.
That is huge. And there you go. I mean, oh man, look, we're just going to pull this fish out. I mean,
look
that
the
there, that really is a once in a lifetime fish. Look at the stomach on it. I can't believe it. You can see the roe starting to come out of it there. That is a very, very big snapper. In fact, I've got a 32 pounder on my wall. And I'm thinking that this fish could be even bigger. Geez, the weight of it. The weight of this thing. Well, there we go. We've slipped the hook out, and I don't want to muck around. I've never seen such a fat snapper in my whole life. I tell you, I'm struggling to hold it. That is big. I just do want a quick photo of that. That will serve as my trophy of this awesome fish. Awesome fish. So now I've got my trophy, we've got to feed, and this fish is gonna go back and make lots and lots of babies, big babies, for our kids to enjoy. Still feeling he wants to go. There he goes, look. Cool. Fire the motors up, bro. I reckon we give him a pop and he'll get away. He's a little bit blown. He's got his swim bladder inflated there. Oh, geez, even lifting him in the second time, he's pretty heavy. He's got plenty of life in him. You can see he's still kicking around a lot. But even though I brought him up slowly, or her up slowly, I should say, and there you go, this one's got the dark chin. So there you go, that answers our question. It is the females with the dark chin, but more pressing. Just in behind here, if I can just put a little poke in there, that's gonna vent. And I'll just check for the swim bladder. You can hear the air coming out of that. Pop the swim bladder inside the mouth. Yeah, it's still got plenty of life. The only reason that fish couldn't get down was because of that air inside the swim bladder that it inflated. Now this time, come on my girl, you're going home. You're going home, baby. See, there she goes. She's powering away down into the depths. Oh yeah!
Woo! Woohoo! Well done. Well done.